If you ever wonder why some patterns in your family history seems to be recurring in your own life, strongholds such as anxiety, poverty, illnesses, and addictions, to name a few. The Bible referred to these generational curses. Exodus 20 verse 5, the Bible says, "You shall not bow down to them and worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the father to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me." If any of your ancestors or you ever visited a voodoo priest for help, a fortune teller, a palm reader, pray to saints or to any other gods, the word of God says he will punish the children for the sin of the parents to the third and fourth generation. God also say in Deuteronomy 24 verse 16, "Parents are not to be put to death for their children, no children put to death for their parents. Each will die for their own sin." What God was saying is he will punish generations to come if they repeat the sin of their forefathers, not because of the sins of their forefathers committed. While your family history has an effect on you, you are not bound by these generational curses. You have the choice to continue in the footsteps of your ancestors and pass on these curses to your children, or with great diligence, you can end those curses over your life and future. You get to decide if the generational curse continues or ends. There is great freedom in breaking a generational curse and creating a healthier relationship for yourself, the people you love, and your generations to follow. As believers in Jesus Christ, you'll find yourself at times encountering several different obstacles to achieving the blessing God has for you. You pray, you fast, you give, and nothing is changing for you. I am here to let you know part of the reason for this could be the sins of your ancestors that God said he will punish for four generations, or you are repeating the sins of your forefathers. The good news is, God's mercy far exceeds his wrath. In Exodus 20, the Bible says, "But showing love to a thousand generations of those who love me and keep my commandments." Family is important to God, and it is clear that he does not think only in terms of individual, but also in terms of generations. Many of us are not aware that generational influence have the ability to bring blessings or bring curses. In Deuteronomy 28, the Bible contains a list of generational curses and blessings. The good news is that generational curse can be stopped today. No matter curses or blessing, it all begins with choices. When we choose to honor God, the blessings flow. Hebrews 9:22 tells us, "According to the law, almost all things are purified with blood, and without the shedding of blood, there is no remission." A generational curse can come to your bloodline, and it can only be canceled by the blood of Jesus. Any curse, be it generational, ancestral, household, marine, they are extremely dangerous. Breaking inherited curses is especially important for your deliverance. In Galatians 3, verse 13 to 14, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us. For it is written, "Cursed is everyone who hangs on a tree, that the blessings of Abraham might come upon the Gentile in Christ Jesus, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith." If you are worried about generational curse, the answer is salvation through Jesus Christ. A Christian is a new creation. The Bible in 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "This means anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun." How can a child of God still be under God's curse? Romans 8 verse 1 says, "So now there is no condemnation for those who belong to Christ Jesus." How do we break generational curse? We have to repent of any sins that's in our life. Have faith in Christ. Romans 12 verse 1 into the Bible says, "Therefore I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you'll be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." Tonight we are going to pray, because the power of prayer can destroy any curse. Be consistent in your prayer life and be determined to destroy the works of the enemy concerning you and your family. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you that the blood of Jesus is able to take away all sins. I pray forgiveness for the sins of my father, of that bloodline, and for all generations. And I ask you to wash me clean now by the blood of the Lamb. I pray for forgiveness for the sins of my mother, and of that bloodline for all generations, and I ask you to wash me clean by the blood of the Lamb. I receive your forgiveness and believe that by your blood I am cleansed from the sins of all generational bloodline. I take the authority I have in my blood covenant with Jesus Christ, and I break all generational curses on my father's side, all generations back, broken now by the blood of the Lamb. I take that same authority and break all generational curse on my mother's side, broken now by the blood of the Lamb. With the same authority I have under the blood covenant of salvation in Jesus, I break any unspoken curses of my family bloodline. I take the same authority in the name of the blood of Jesus, and I break all covenants and contracts to Satan, including blood covenant contracts. I pray forgiveness for the sins of my family line of all those things that have happened in darkness, such as any attachment to slavery or any kind of persecution or mistreatment, any abuse of any people, groups, or individual. And I pray blessing for all descendants of the persecuted groups or individual. I pray forgiveness for the sins of all idolatry. I also break any attachment to family superstitions and idolatries, ungodly gifts, wife's tales, any luck charms, any rhyme curses in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus, that your word says, "Cursed is the one who hangs on the tree." You took our curses, you took our sins, so that we can have a life more abundantly, and we praise you for it. I receive by faith that now all generational sins and all generational curses are broken by the blood of the Lamb in Jesus' name. I break all the generational curse of pride, of rebellion, of lust and poverty, of witchcraft and idolatry, death and destruction, failure and sickness, infirmity and fear, and rejection in the name of Jesus. I command all generational spirits operating in my life through curses to be bound and cast out in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ. I command all spirit of lust, spirit of perversion and adultery, spirit of fornication, uncleanness, spirit of immorality to come out right now. Come out in the name of Jesus. I command all spirit of hurt, of rejection, of fear, spirit of anger or wrath, of sadness and depression, discouragement and grief, bitterness and unforgiveness to come out of my emotions in the name of Jesus. I command all spirit of confusion, of forgetfulness, of mind control, of mental illness, double-mindedness, fantasy, pains, pride, and memory recall to come out of my mind today in the name of Jesus. I break all curses and commandment of all spirit of double-mindedness and rejection, spirit of rebellion and root of bitterness to come out in the name of Jesus. I command all spirit of guilt, shame, and condemnation to come out of my conscience in the name of Jesus. I command all spirits of pride and stubbornness, disobedience, rebellion, self-will and selfishness and arrogance to come out of my will in the name of Jesus. Father God, your word says that you have adopted me into your family. Therefore, I am Abraham's descendant and heir together with Christ. From today onwards, I refuse to walk in the curse of my family and choose to walk in the blessings of Abraham. I break free from every curse that has spoken over me by my family, my friends, even strangers. Jesus Christ, I confess and I proclaim that you are my Savior and Lord over my life. I proclaim that the stripes you bore on the cross of Calvary has established you, my Redeemer. I repent of every relative connected to my family ancestry who have deliberately or without spiritual wisdom sinned against my God Jehovah. I realize that all sins will be judged one day and that each one of us is accountable for what we have said or done. But I am repenting for my family's sins and that I shall be released from any curse these sins may have produced against me. I atone for every family member from my heritage who has entered into sinful paths and who have opened doors never before opened, giving Satan greater influence over their lives and the lives of their children. I intercede the blood of Jesus Christ, and I command the roots of these curses that have engraved themselves against me and my family members to be uprooted and destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. To be uprooted and destroyed in the same way that Jesus has spoken words against the fig tree in Matthew 21, verse 19 to 20. And that fig tree withered away and die. Let these curses die now in Jesus' mighty name. Father, your word says, Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law, having been made a curse for me. Therefore, I break and command every generational curse and the manifestation of sickness, of disease, dysfunctional lifestyle, failed marriages, character flaws, financial poverty, spiritual oppression, addiction, death, and destruction of myself, past generations, and all future generations today in Jesus' name. I place the cross between all past generation and myself. Every curse and assignment must stop at the cross in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord, that I am now free from any and all generational curse in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I renounce and repent of any sin that may have opened up. I ask that you forgive me of every known and unknown sin whatsoever that gave the devil ground to be able to afflict me with curses in Jesus' name. Father, I want to thank you for your provision in Christ for my redemption and deliverance from every or any curse in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I declare that every curse in my life break now by the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus for my release in Jesus' name. Father, I declare that no weapon formed against me in the form of curses shall succeed against me anymore from today in Jesus' name. Father, because your word declares that no curse can touch Jacob and that no sorcery has power against Israel, I declare that I am the seed of Abraham. No curse from today onwards can touch me. No witchcraft spells has power over me again in Jesus' name. Lord, nothing is impossible with you. I declare that every stubborn curse in my life be broken and shattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, your word declares that even the captive of the mighty shall be taken away and the prayer of the terrible shall be delivered. Now, Lord, contend with every curse in my life and deliver me in Jesus' name. Father, your word declares that you will bless everyone who blesses me and curse all who curse me. I am the seed of Abraham in Jesus Christ. Curse, Lord, everyone who curses me. Lord, your word declares that if any man is in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. I declare therefore that the old things of curses and spell have passed away from my life in Jesus' name. Father, again, I ask that you forgive me of every sin, known and unknown, that has given the devil a hold to oppress me with curses. Forgive me in Jesus' name. I refuse to give places to the devil. Lord, I know that my fight is not with humans, but with evil spirit that's empowered the curses to take effect. Now, Lord, I come against every evil spirit behind any curse in my life. I bind you and command you to desist from your operations over my life in the name of Jesus. Lord, I submit my all to you, spirit, soul, and body. And I therefore resist the devil and his curses and the spirits that give power to the curses. Flee from me now in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I take authority over every curse operating in my life right now. I bind the demon behind, working it. I stop your operations now in Jesus' name. By the power and authority that Jesus delegated to me, I declare every curse cease to operate in my life today, and I cast out the demon behind it. Lord, as I pray, I ask that you help me not to hold anybody in mind who may be responsible for releasing the curse. I forgive them all. In the name of Jesus, and by the righteousness which is of faith, I overcome every curse and evil that have been perpetrated a long time in my life by the servants of Satan. I prevail over you by the blood of the Lamb and by my testimony of the power in the blood of Christ. Lord, as your minister and servant of righteousness and good, I pronounce your wrath against and upon every servant of Satan that Satan has used to afflict me with curses in Jesus' name. May they be blinded and dumb forever, and may the curse come on them and their families in Jesus' name. By the word of the Lord, I declare my freedom from curses. I declare that the law of the Spirit of life is Christ Jesus, set me free from the law of sin, curses of death in Jesus' name. Father, I declare that by the blood of Jesus, every pronouncement, every spell, written or verbal, against me be canceled, recalled, and blotted out now in Jesus' name. I reverse them all in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for teaching me to war with your word in your name. I destroy curses in the name of the Lord, and by your holy written word in Jesus' name, I am free. I am blessed and liberated now. In Jesus' name, I pray.